evidence presented by the
Let's listen into the verdict.
And the defense finds you, Radovan Karadzic, not guilty of count one, genocide. Guilty of the following counts. Count two, genocide. Count three, persecution, a crime against humanity. Count four, extermination, a crime against humanity. Count five, murder, a crime against humanity. Count six, murder, a violation of the laws or customs of war. Count seven, deportation, a crime against humanity. Count eight, forcible transfer as other inhumane acts, a crime against humanity. Count nine, terror, a violation of the laws or customs of war. Count 10, unlawful attacks on civilians or violation of the laws or customs of war. And count 11, hostage taking or violation of the laws or customs of war. The chamber hereby sentences you, Radovan Karadzic, to a single sentence of 40 years of imprisonment. Please be seated, Mr. Karadzic. The accused has been in custody since the 21st of July 2008, and pursuant to Rule 101C of the rules, is entitled to credit for time spent in detention thus far. Pursuant to Rule 103C of the rules, the accused shall remain in the custody of the tribunal pending the finalization of arrangement for his transfer to the state where he shall serve his sentence. Judge Howard Morrison and Judge Melville Baird append partially dissenting opinions to the judgment. The court stands adjourned.
All right.
So the UN judges leave the court, having delivered the sentence. The presiding judge, O-Gon Kwon, who read the verdict, which I hope you heard clearly, not guilty of genocide. That's one of the two counts of genocide, but guilty of all the other charges that were brought to him. One single sentence, said the judge, of 40 years, but pursuant to one of the laws, he has been in detention since 2008, so there will be a compensation. We're not clear exactly how long he has been sentenced for, but initially 40 years.